You probably know that wastewater exits buildings and homes through toilets and drains, and then is sent to a collection site. But how exactly does it get to where it needs to go? In this video, we will break down exactly what a lift station is and how they work. As mentioned before, wastewater travels from a building or house to a regional collection site. It flows downhill through underground pipes. But this becomes a problem when it reaches a low point where gravity can no longer keep it flowing. This is where lift stations are critical. They are installed at these low points to pump or lift the flow of wastewater to higher ground, allowing it to flow downhill from gravity again. To get a better understanding of what goes on inside a lift station, let's take a closer look. When the flow of wastewater enters a lift station, it collects in the underground tank called a wet well. As the wastewater continues to collect and rise, the water level is measured by hanging sensors called floats. Once the water rises to a certain level, pumps are activated and force wastewater out through a pipeline called a forced main. For smaller sized lift stations, most pumps are submersible in the wet well, but for larger, more complex lift stations, the pump is often placed in a separate room from the wet well to allow for easier access and maintenance. Lift stations also contain an above-ground structure that houses other equipment to maintain proper operation of the lift station. Access into the wet well is locked off with hatches since the wet well system can be very dangerous. For any other questions about lift stations and wastewater solutions, visit www.stateindustrial.com to get in contact with us.